1 year ago, my good buddy Tory Brock called and said he had seen a giant bull. I kind of chuckled where he said he'd seen the bull. We had picked up more elk sheds there than anywhere else, and we had never found anything of that size. So later in the spring, Mike Hutchings and I searched for the sheds, only to have walked 200 yards from them. You see, Mossback guide Caleb Taylor found one of them a month later, and the word came to me by Mike Eastman, and boy, were we excited.
Holy! Take a look at that!
Come on, hold on, hold on.
Right off the road.
My heck, Mike was here the other day. He must have drove right by it.
Somebody drove right by it in four-wheeler tracks.
No way. Hold him up. Oh.
Been in the brush?
I took some ribbing from my guides because 3 years ago on the DVD Scream Bulls 3, I made this prediction. After word spread that the giant bull was the largest ever taken in the state, it has been speculated that this trophy would never be surpassed. But in February, a friend of mine called me about a bull he had just seen. I went and videotaped this giant, non-typical bull. Could the bookless produce the next 400-inch bull? Will he exceed the new state record? Only time will tell. No one could believe that such a monster could come from the bookless. But after scoring the shed with an average spread of 40 inches, it became clear that this bull had the potential to be the largest bull ever, and for sure the world record with a bow. Now the trick was, we needed a tag. I spent 4 months trying to buy one. About a week before the archery hunt started, a nice guy, Tom, finally sold me a landowner tag, and the hunt was on. So we all continued to scout, even harder for the bull. Jace Farnsworth was sent to search for the bull. Days turned into weeks, and weeks over a month. Finally, 4 days before the late season, Jace had located a giant 6x6 within 500 yards of where the sheds were picked up. After viewing the footage, it was obvious it was the same bull. Opening day found Ron, Tori, and I stalking the bull with spotters Jace Farnsworth, Wayne Brown, Caleb Taylor, and Mike Eastman on points, keeping tabs on him.
Shoot again, shoot again.
Nice shot, Rod. Faster, run.
That's a bull.
Killed a giant.
Stay on him, let's just make sure he don't move. That was a great shot.
The longest walk of a hunter's life over to his trophy animal.
This meadow, this little flat right here, you know what lied here in March?
Shed freak.
This is where your bull shed. Shed was right in this little spot right there where Caleb picked it up.
So it ended where it began. This is unbelievable.
That's sick. Look at that first mass. It's over 11. Oh,
so sick. Sick, good. Yeah. Look at the.
It's absolutely ridiculous.
Look at the pills. He did have an extra. He had an extra. They're all broke. Oh, that one. Yeah. Is that tungsten? Yeah.
That is.
Do you have his right side? Unbelievable.
I don't even know what that side. This, look at the time length on this thing. It's a cartoon.
Well, here we are. Ron, congratulations on a giant.
Thanks, Darryl.
Why don't you recap the morning?
Well, we had some of the Mossback team on some of these ridges trying to spot this elk. Jason's been living with this thing for the last week and spotted the companion to this bull right away, and then this bull popped up on this ridge. And once we heard that, we got him. We moved in for the kill from across the canyon here and ranged him at about 370 yards and made a halfway decent shot on this bull, and he just dropped right in his tracks. And
Shoot again.
Got over this bull, and this beast is just beyond description. He is just a phenomenal bull. Caleb here found the shed to this bull just a couple hundred yards from here, and like a lot of these trophy animals, they have a core area they come to, and he's right here. But this is a phenomenal 6x6 bull that these guys found. And like all the great Mossback kills, it's a tremendous team effort with all these guys. I've hunted with these guys now for 5 years, and this is the topper right here. It doesn't get any better. I'm having a hard time getting it out. It's just a real special experience.
So. Third 400 bull with us in 3 out of 4 years.
Yeah, it's almost embarrassing to talk about 3 4-inch bulls. It's another lifetime bull, if you can say that. Yeah. And I always say it's so much more special to be with your dear friends to kill a bull like that.
Absolutely. This all started a year ago. Tory Brock and his hunter was in here hunting deer. He called me on the phone immediately. He said he spotted a giant. Mike Hutchings and I came in here looking for his sheds. We walked within a couple hundred yards of him. Caleb Taylor came in and found one side, the giant 7-point side on the right. And we searched all summer. Jace lived out of his truck all summer, and Caleb and everybody. We all came down and put a lot of time in it. And Jace came back in about 4 days ago and found him. And great team effort. Wayne Brown and Mike Eastman was all down. What's he gonna score, Ron?
He taped out here on the mountain at 432. Well, I love seeing that number. That's great. And I think he's gonna net, in the mid 420s. And the number doesn't do this bull justice. It's just, he's so beautiful and symmetrical. And oh man, it's just a great feeling to be in the company of this kind of animal.
We had potentially killed the state record about a month and a half ago, and this bull blew the doors off that bull. So he's just a pig. He's got 22 and 23 inch fronts and 25 inch royals, 17 inch fifths, 58 inch beams, 32 inches of mass. He is a bit narrow, as you can see, but we really didn't care. He's 38 or 34 inside, so just a giant bull.
And he's ours.
Congratulations to everybody.
Yeah, thank you so much for a great effort.
Congratulations to Ron and all the help on such a giant bull. This bull, with only a 34 inch inside spread and 51 outside, grosses 433 inches and nets right around 426, making him pending number 4 in the world and Utah's greatest typical ever. So what's Ron going to do next year? Well, he says he's finally gonna kill one with his bow. We will see. Here we are with Ron Skoronski's 433 grossing bull that he killed in the year of 2006. What we're gonna show you is the comparison to a shed. His shed was picked up by Mossback guide Caleb Taylor. And this antler alone, with a 60 inch main beam and a 7.5 inch extra, grosses 204 and change by itself. Well, this year when we killed him, the bull, this side alone is almost 203. So he's only about an inch and a half difference, and he lost 5 inches on his main beam and a 7.5 inch extra. And he put that all in a 6-point side. So it's just amazing to see the two giant antlers side by side.